Hello and welcome to the lecture session. Today I am going to discuss about the type 4 problems and the complex variable one. It is a mixed type of problems. Find analytic function f of z is equal to u plus iv given u minus v is equal to e power x into cos y minus sin y. In this type, what happens is, before going to the problem, I would like to give a few glimpse of this one. They will be giving you the combination of u and v. Either it can be u plus or u minus v. It can be in the Cartesian or in the polar form. So, we need to find an analytic function by using this. So, let us see this problem. They have given u minus v as e to the power of x into cos y minus sin y. Differentiating with respect to x partially, we get to ux minus vx is equal to e power x into cos y minus sin y. Let's call this as 1. Again, differentiating with respect to y, uy minus vy as e power x into minus sin y minus cos y. So, we get it as equation 2. Here, you need to eliminate either v or u so that you will be getting any one of this. That is either 2ux you will get it or 2v. Like this we will be getting it. From the CR equations, that is ux is equal to vy and vx is equal to minus uy. So in the second equation, minus vx minus ux is equal to this one. This implies by cancelling the minus on both the sides, ux plus vx is equal to e to the power of x into sin y plus cos y. Call this as equation number 3. So, solving the first equation and then the third equation where ux and vx is there, we will get eliminated. Either you can subtract and then eliminate or add. So, 2vx is given by e power 2e power 2x into sin y. So, 2 and 2 cancels, vx is given by e power x into sin y. And ux will be equal to, that is on substitution, ux will be obtained as e power x into cos y. So, f dash of z is equal to ux plus ivx, we know that. So, let us replace e ux plus ivx, that is e power x cos y plus I e power x sin y. And put x is equal to z and y is equal to 0, we get f dash of z is equal to e power z, because cos 0 is 1 and sin 0 is 0, so the imaginary part will be totally 0. We get it as only e power z as a f dash of z. So, once we get the f dash of z, we need to integrate in order to get the f of z. So, integral of f of z is also e power z, but it is with a constant. Next. If f of z is a regular function of z, show that dou by dou x of modulus of f of z whole square plus dou by dou y mod f of z whole square is equal to mod f dash of z the whole square. Let f of z is equal to u plus iv is regular. Regular in the sense analytic or holomorphic. So, the modulus of f of z is root of u square plus v square. That is the imaginary square and the real part whole square and imaginary part whole square, that we will call this as phi. So, we prove that dou phi by dou x the whole square plus dou phi by dou y the whole square is equals to mod of f dash of z the whole square. This is what is required. Dou phi by this f of z, mod f of z is written as phi. So, instead of writing dou phi by dou by dou x of mod f of z every time, let us replace this by phi so that it will be 5x square plus 5y square is equal to mod of this one. At phi is equal to u square plus v square under the root. So, squaring on both the sides, phi square is equal to u square plus v square. Call this as 1. Now, differentiating with respect to x, we get 2 phi into 5x is equal to 2u ux plus 2v vx. Cancelling 2 on either side, we get this. And similarly, differentiating with respect to y, 2 phi phi x, phi y is equal to 2u uy plus 2v vy. Call this as equation number 3. squaring and adding that, we get 4 phi square 5x square plus 4 phi square 5y square is equal to 2u ux plus 2v vx the whole square and 2u uy plus 2v vy the whole square. Here 4 phi square can be taken outside, 5x square plus 5y square will be there. And in the right hand side, since it is a plus b whole square form, we will get another form also, that is the 2uv into, that is 2ab term also we will be getting it. And here 2 is taken before squaring, so 2 square will be 4, so 4 is outside for both the brackets. So we get it as u square ux square plus v square vx square plus 2uv into ux vx. And the second bracket is u square uy square plus v square vy square and 2uv into vy uy. And from the CR equations, we know that ux is equals to vy and vx is equals to minus uy. So 4 times of u square ux square plus v square vx square plus 2uv ux vx, that remains the same, the first bracket. In the second bracket, we are going to replace it with minus vx, that is uy is replaced with the minus vx, vy is replaced with the ux, and so. So we will be getting minus of 2uv into ux vx, so that these two terms gets cancelled. So we get 4 times of u square into ux plus vx the whole square, ux square plus v square, again v square into ux square and vx square. We can take ux square plus vx square out, means we get it as u square plus v square, that we can write it as phi square, ux square and vx square. So here 4 phi square cancels on either side, we get 5x square plus 5y square is equals to ux square plus vx square. And let phi f dash of z is equals to ux plus ivx. So mod of f dash of z is equal to root of ux square plus vx square. This implies mod of f dash z whole square is equals to ux square plus vx square. Call this as phi. Equating the right hand side, 1 and 5, we get 5x square plus 5y square, 4 and 5. We get a 5x square plus 5y square is equals to mod of f dash of z whole square. Or this implies dou by dou x of f of z mod whole square is equal plus dou by dou y mod f of z whole square is equals to mod f dash of z the whole square. This proves the result. Next, if phi of xy is a differentiable function and f of z is equals to u of xy plus iv of xy is a regular function, show that dou phi by dou x whole square plus dou phi by dou y whole square is equal to dou phi by dou y whole square plus dou phi by dou v whole square into mod of f dash of z the whole square. Let us treat phi as a composite function, treating phi to be a function of u and v, and u and v as a function of x and y. And we know by the chain rule, dou phi by dou x can be written as dou phi by dou u by dou x plus dou phi by dou v by dou x, or phi x is equals to phi u ux plus phi v vx. Similarly, phi y or dou phi by dou y can be written as dou phi by dou u into dou u by dou y plus dou phi by dou v into dou v by dou y, or phi y can be written as phi u uy plus phi v vy. Therefore, phi x square plus phi y square, that is squaring this equation and this equation and adding, we get phi u ux plus phi v vx the whole square plus phi u uy plus phi v vy the whole square. And again here also 2ab term we get it, and here also the 2ab term we will get it. Therefore, phi u the whole square, phi u square ux square plus phi v square vx square plus 2 times of phi u ux phi v vx. Here the second bracket, phi u square uy square plus phi v square vy square plus 2 phi u uy into phi v vy. And here these terms gets cancelled because of the CR equations. By replacing the CR equations, it will become minus of this one. That is, ux is vy and vx is uy, minus uy. So this is phi u square ux square plus phi v square vx square plus 2 phi u into ux phi v into vx plus phi u square minus vx square plus phi v square ux square minus 2 phi u ux phi v vx. And these two terms gets cancelled. That is, this term and this term gets cancelled. So we get phi u square into ux square plus vx square plus phi v square into ux square plus v square. So this ux square plus vx square is taken common. Then we get phi u square plus phi v square. And this is f dash of z is ux plus ivx. So its modulus is ux square plus vx square. And f dash z the whole square is ux square plus vx square. So in the right hand side of the first equation, we will replace. So we are getting phi u square plus phi v square into mod of f dash of z the whole square. Thank you.